Dina, I would like to ask you regarding a couple of points. One is, can you share some of these problems that are unsolved according to you or in process of being solved? You know, these would be the white spaces that founders can work on or can start building products on. So if you could just give your a few points on that as well.
So Shivam, white spaces, I would say that the way to look at it the way to look at it is the entire spectrum of today's interaction, how from a consumer to the banking side, which is coming. So the silos, breaking it and getting it as a single mechanism is one is the way in which things are evolving going forward. Because nobody needs to have, it has always been, if you look at it, traditionally also, the bundling, unbundling has always been a theme which happens in every wave of innovation. And currently that we see in the payment space, India has evolved quite a lot in terms of, you know, being the right from the money movement to the infrastructure, to the regulations, to if you look at the government way, also the way in which it is going right from the UPI all the way to currently when we see the account aggregator to the PAPG to the settlements, which are right from a PPI who has good access to the NEFT, RTG. I mean, path breaking ways in which, you know, the partnerships are coming up in terms of things are opening up for more entrants, more intermediaries, all of them to solve for what a customer requires. So the way to look at it is if you have to create a thread of end to end, there are two ways in which, one, there would be one who would be interacting with the customer and solving for their problems. The way in which you do that would also differ from, which means there is going to be a whole lot of layer which has to back it up because it cannot be full stack all the time when you are looking at a bundled solution. So which is where right from, you know, the rails, which is also on the right from the infrastructure, be it banking, be it on the wealth, insurance, everything which is coming from different regulators to the rails, which has to come from regulation onward to the solution part of it. Then the way in which the customer is onboarding. I mean, the onboarding part is also a critical piece right now because what happens is that how seamless and frictionless the solution is for the customer is going to determine how much he's going to adopt it faster, because this is a habit change that is happening. So it's not always, habit changes doesn't come overnight. And that's exactly where you have to create a frictionless experience, less cognitive load, and that's the only way in which you can be, which is where the other white space also remains to be, again, you know, the onboarding part of it, or rather how easily you can handhold the customer into something, which is where the experience part happens. And the third portion, the biggest thing is the data privacy and the consent mechanism, which again, one has to look at whether it has to be, all of these we're talking about, right from the infra, There are two ways in which to look at it from an opportunity perspective. One is which is going to be the volume which you remain a solution which powers at a wide, much wider scale, both, you know, within domestic, international, because everywhere the framework would be the same. That remains a volume driven, you know, the powering tech service provider kind of. And then there is other aspect in each of this, which is also a bundled part of the solutioning for the customer, which is where, you know, it goes to, like, it could be a B2C or a B2B or a SaaS or different modes in which you are looking at the pie of a certain opportunity and a particular solution that you are looking for. So these areas right from this will be the three distinct areas, and then comes the end slice of what you interact with the customer. It can be a B2B or a B2C, whichever way one is looking at in terms of, you know, what you want to really solve for. And if you look at the pain points, there are especially wealth for that matter. While all of this is 360 degrees still, wealth is an area wherein there has to be quite a lot of innovation, as Sita also rightly mentioned about an augmented reality, right from, you know, having a life to what you really want, from determining what a customer needs from an end goal, what they have, because two, three things are very critical and differs from customer to customer. Your ability to take risk and what for you are solving the wealth part for, right? And this array of, there is an array of things. And then as a result, when things come together for a customer, there are a whole lot of ways in which they're going to see it as a positive or a negative. For example, if you give them somebody a high risk portfolio wherein they have absolutely no mind to do it, that's going to be a problem. But at the same time, how do you understand without asking him too many questions, you know? And how do you understand their unstated needs by understanding them in a 360 degree way in various other ways? So those are the areas one should be looking for, because we are getting into more and more of the trend wherein you have to fight what the customer needs and solve for. And most of the time, the customer themselves don't know because they're so used to the way in which things are. They themselves don't know what they need. So it is for the entrepreneur to find out from certain spaces. It could be you have the choice of focusing on a particular segment, a particular cohort, a particular customer need. For example, we still see neobanks in there. Even when you talk about consumer neobanks, right, it could be like a solution completely based on cards plus an account. It could be for the students who are going abroad, for that matter. So these are all specific cross-border. So there are all specific needs and problems which are being sorted out. So these are the spaces one need to really keep an eye open for. Who is having the biggest issue today, which can be solved by technology and by the innovation that is happening? So those are the white spaces, I would say. Look at segment-wise, look at who is struggling the most. Again, cross-border is another which one has to solve for, because people are going, like after the pandemic, now we started off like traveling and, you know, studies and job and whatnot and what more, and different places are having different kind of, you are being assisted in a certain way in your home country, but that doesn't carry a value when you go out. What do you do there? Like porting of what you are, what your standing is. So this is some of the areas one can really look at as a white space, and then look at the segments and solve for what is required in the market.